B-Monster Laboratory here. I hope each one of you are doing great. Today we're going to make an Arduino setup using a temperature and humidity sensor with an LCD display. This corresponds with lesson 12 in your Elegoo Mega 2560 tutorial. We're going to learn a little bit about the DHT11 sensor. This one's going to be really fun. In this video, we'll be using the Elegoo Mega 2560 microcontroller. We'll be using the DHT11 Humidity and Temperature Sensor, a 10K potentiometer, and the 1602A LCD module. It's right here. And we'll be using a whole bunch of the male-to-male jumper wires, as you can see. Here is the DHT11 Humidity and Temperature Sensor. This is the one that came with the Elegoo Mega kit that I purchased. And it has three pins. It's got a VCC pin, a data pin, and a ground pin. Now you may just be looking online to buy one of these, and it doesn't have the breakout board. This one's got a breakout board. The one that doesn't, it's just a sensor, will have four pins, and with that one, you will have to use a 10K ohm resistor as a pull-up resistor between the VCC pin and the data pin to keep it high so that the sensor and the microcontroller can communicate properly. But with the breakout board, you have a built-in resistor right there. But if you do buy the 4-pin sensor alone, you will have to use that 10K ohm resistor. This one operates on 5 volts. It has a humidity range of 20 to 90% and a temperature range of 0 to 50 degrees Celsius. Now there is another type of DHT humidity and temperature sensor, and that's the DHT22. It is quite a bit bigger than this one, and it has a humidity range of 0 to 100% and a temperature range of negative 40 to 80 degrees Celsius. So it is more accurate, but this one is cheaper and a little more compact. You may want to check out the DHT22, just depending on your application. But for anything we have planned, this one will be just fine. So when the sensor measures humidity, it's based on the change in resistance, and that resistance is proportional to the amount of water vapor that it can detect. And the DHT11 uses NTC temperature measurement devices, and it connects with a high-performance 8-bit microcontroller. NTC stands for negative temperature coefficient. Now the DHT22 uses an NTC component called a thermistor, but the DHT11, the sensor I'm holding here in my hand, uses other NTC components such as probes and assemblies. They all work much the same way. They use resistance properties to measure temperature. If you recall, a thermistor is a thermal resistor, and it also changes resistance based on temperature. And I did a video on a thermistor a while back, and I'll be happy to link that in the description below if you're interested in watching that. And for the setup here on my breadboard, I have the VCC and the ground pin connected to the positive and negative rail up here on my breadboard. I have the data pin connected to pin 2 on my microcontroller. I have the standard setup for the LCD module, and the data pins I'm using are D4 through D7, and those correspond with pin 9 through 12 over here on my microcontroller. And I'll include a schematic so that you can see exactly how this is set up. Here's the schematic. I've included the temperature humidity sensor on the right, the potentiometer on the left, and the Mega 2560 board and the LCD module right there in the middle. Here's the code that we used for this video, and don't forget to include your LCD module library and your humidity and temperature sensor library. And come down here and you're going to designate pin number 2 as your data pin for your sensor. And down here we're going to say that these pins right here correspond with these positions on the LCD module, which is the register select pin, enable pin, and the data pins D4 through D7. If we come down here, we see that our LCD module has 16 columns and 2 rows. And this will print exactly as you see it here on the LCD module with temperature and humidity up at the top row. Down here in the loop, we have a half a second a delay, and then we set our cursor at 0, 1. You remember the first position on the LCD module is 0, 0. So 0, 1 is the first column, second row. And at that point, we're going to display our humidity and then our temperature. And then down here, we get the parameters for an error message, which says that if humidity and Fahrenheit, which is temperature here, is not a number, if it falls within these parameters, you get the error message. And you shouldn't get the error message unless you connected it incorrectly or if your sensor is damaged. So that shouldn't be an issue. If you're interested and you're looking for this code, I will have all this posted on the channel Facebook page. So here's my final setup. I had to let it sit for a few minutes to so the temperature wouldn't be jumping all over the place. We have an outdoor weather station, and it also offers an indoor humidity and temperature reading, and I'm comparing it to that. It's close. It's about one off on both temperature and humidity. Now, we did get a whole bunch of rain, and it is a little warm, so maybe if I left it plugged in a little bit longer, it would continue to acclimate a little bit more. I do think it'd be an interesting little experiment to test the DHT11 against the DHT22 and see which one is closer to the to our little weather station here. But I'm pretty happy with this, and hope you give it a shot. Well, that's all I've got for today. I do appreciate you watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And also, check out some of our other Arduino videos. If you like those, consider subscribing to the channel. And I'll see you again very soon.